Discussion on treadmill exercise ECG, also known as treadmill test, TMT and stress ECG. Treadmill exercise ECG is usually done with a computerized treadmill unit which controls the motor speed of the treadmill as well as monitors the ECG. Please subscribe to this channel for future updates. Click on the subscribe button. Press the bell icon after that for all updates. ECG is recorded periodically during the test in addition to documenting any specific events like arrhythmias. Ideally, treadmill test is done in a basal state so that the process of digestion of food and consequent increase in cardiac output does not interfere with the assessment. If it is a diagnostic test, the individual should be off medications. But if it is for assessment of effort tolerance while on treatment, it may be done on medications. Though various protocols like Norton and RAM protocol are in vogue, the popular one is Bruce protocol. There is also a modified Bruce protocol for those with lower functional capacity or for early post-infarction evaluation. Standard Bruce protocol has 7 3-minute stages. In stage 1, the gradient is 10% and it rises 2% per stage. The starting speed is 1.7 miles per hour and increases in increments of 0.8 to 0.9 miles per hour per stage. In modified Bruce protocol, stage 1 has a gradient of 0 and stage 2 a gradient of 5%. Speed is the same in first 3 stages of modified Bruce protocol, that is 1.7 miles per hour. Stage 3 of modified Bruce protocol is equivalent to stage 1 of standard Bruce protocol. Further stages are similar to Bruce protocol, though the number of the stage will be higher by a magnitude of 2. Treadmill exercise test ECG series starts with a pre-test ECG and recordings in every stage of exercise and recovery phase. Sometimes an ECG during hyperventilation is also recorded before the start of exercise. This pre-test ECG of a treadmill exercise test series shows a bit of artifacts, especially in leads 2 and 3. The pre-test heart rate is about 100 per minute, possibly due to apprehension. ECG recording in stage 1 of the Bruce protocol of treadmill exercise test. The heart rate has increased and there are not many artifacts and no significant ST segment shift is evident. Recording at the peak exercise shows significant horizontal ST segment depression in inferior and lateral leads at a fast heart rate. But the significant level of artifacts in the raw rhythm strip make us suspect whether the ST segment depression could be artifactual due to computerized averaging in the computer synthesized rhythm. The recording in early phase of recovery at 1 minute shows very little ST segment depression, making us suspect further whether the earlier recording was really due to myocardial ischemia. But the ST segment is downsloping in inferior leads. ECG at 3 minutes of recovery shows further worsening of ST segment depression in inferior and lateral leads, establishing the presence of significant myocardial ischemia. TMT recovery phase ECG at 6 minutes showing the persistence of downsloping ST segment depression. This calls for further evaluation including coronary angiography and revascularization if feasible. Moreover, ECG recording has to be continued till the ST segment shift resolves. Another exercise ECG showing deep ST depression in inferior and anterolateral leads with ST segment elevation in AVR and V1 in stage 1. This test also calls for angiography and revascularization if feasible. Basal metabolic requirement is taken as 1 met or metabolic equivalent, which is equivalent to 3.5 ml per kg per minute of oxygen consumption. If stage 1 of Bruce protocol is completed, 4.6 mets are achieved. For stage 2, it is 7 and 10.1 for stage 3. The treadmill speeds at these stages are 1.7, 2.5 and 3.4 miles per hour respectively. For stage 4, the speed is 4.2 miles per hour. The most important change noted in treadmill test is the ST segment depression as seen in the illustration. If it occurs in stage 1 of standard Bruce protocol and if it is severe, it is a strongly positive TMT as in this illustration. The lower the workload at which the ST segment depression occurs, the more likely the person is to have severe coronary artery disease. ST segment depression occurring within 5 minutes of Bruce protocol and persisting more than 5 minutes into recovery is highly significant. ST segment depression can be upsloping, horizontal or downsloping in the order of increasing significance. An upsloping ST segment depression can be normal if it is a rapid upsloping ST, which is said to represent the atrial repolarization wave or TA wave extending into the region of the ST segment with exercise. ST segment depression is measured at 80 milliseconds from the J point at the end of the QRS at heart rates below 120 per minute and at 60 milliseconds at higher heart rates. ST segment elevation has the same significance as ST segment depression in leads not showing an initial Q wave. In those leads with a Q wave, it can be due to dyskinesia or left ventricular aneurysm. It can also be a feature of viable myocardium in an infarcted territory with poor collateralization. Hibernating myocardium has been invoked as a reason by Maloff and Associates as their patient had resolution of wall motion abnormalities after revascularization. Coronary spasm is another potential cause of ST elevation during treadmill exercise ECG. In one study, 12 patients without history of myocardial infarction or left ventricular aneurysm had provocation of coronary spasm with ergonovin. Here are the first set of references on ST elevation during exercise ECG. Second set of references are here. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for future updates and click on the bell icon for all updates. Thank you.